Hello everyone, welcome back to this session and DevOps training. Today in this session, we're going to discuss what is DevOps. All right, so without wasting any time, let's go ahead and start with this session. So guys, like I told you guys earlier, DevOps is nothing but a methodology. It is an idea, right? It is not a tool, it is not a software. It's an idea or methodology of solving the problems between developer and operations guys, right? Now, this methodology involves a life cycle, which as you can see in the diagram that the first thing that you do is you plan what you have to do, right? Then you code your way in, then you build the code. Building the code means if you have a Java file, for example, you'll have to create a jar file or an executable file out of that. So that is called building, right? So building your code, and then you will be testing your code. So what executable you have built, you'll basically test that code for any faults in the functionalities. And if there are no faults, you'll basically release the code to the ops team. Now there are two kinds of release guys. There's an internal release and there's an external release, right? The internal release talks about releasing the software to a different team of the company, and this is what exactly is happening. Then comes the release phase where the developer guys release the software to the operation guys for their work, right? The operations guy will in turn deploy the software onto the target system. It could be a testing server which basically will test or do automated test on it, or it could be, you know, the production server where everything has happened, the testing has happened, and you're deploying it on the production server, right? So once you have deployed it, of course, now becomes the operation phase. The operation phase can be done internally, or it could be done by your customers, wherein you know, you're operating the software or you release the software for internal employees to see whether you know, the traffic, when is it doing good, when it holds, when it's getting traffic onto it, is it doing good when normal people are doing arbitrary tasks on your software. And then you are also continuously monitoring it to see if you know, your task is or your application is functioning properly, and if it is not functioning properly, you're basically creating a log of events which are happening, right? Which this is called monitoring. And after monitoring, again comes the planning phase, which means if you get any kind of feedback from the monitoring part, you again start planning it, how to do it, how to solve this kind of a problem that you're getting in the monitoring phase, and then code your way in, build the code, again test it, again release it to the ops guy. And this goes on and on until you get the perfect application. And there is no perfect application, guys, right? Always there'll be new requirements coming in, always there'll be some bugs, always there'll be some security patches, and therefore this life cycle goes on and on. So this is what DevOps is, guys, right? And if you were to think about it, how is it solving the problem between the dev and the ops guys? Is by automating this life cycle. Basically, that means that now the developer does not have to give the code to the ops guy. It'll basically be given through a tool which we have, which, so there is a tool called Docker, right? So basically the dev guy will enclose his code inside Docker and will push it to the ops team, and the ops team just have to run Docker and this code will run fine, right? There is no problem for dependency, there is no problem for configuration management. Everything happens automatically in this life cycle. So don't worry if you don't understand exactly what DevOps is, because in our next slides we are going to discuss how it actually works, right? So going forward, now let's discuss how the DevOps life cycle actually works, right? So if you were to that infinity sign that we had, it, if you were to condense it, or if you were to expand it, so that DevOps lifecycle diagram that we had, the infinity diagram that we had, if you were to expand it, it would look something like this, right? So you have something called as planning, you have something called as coding, building, and testing. Now this used to happen on the developer's side, right? And then we go on to the ops side, where we have release, we have deploy, you have operate, and then you have monitor. Right. So in between this, we have to integrate this part of the developer's side to this side of the operator's side. And this is done using continuous integration. Now, what is continuous integration? We'll discuss in a while. But for integrating the developer and the operations guys, we use continuous integration. Right. Now, before moving on to what is continuous integration, let's pay attention to what we have over here as well, right? So the planning and coding phase, we contribute or we collectively call it as continuous development. What is continuous development? I'll explain you in a little while. Building and testing, we call it continuous testing, okay? Releasing and deploying, we call it continuous deployment. Operation and monitoring, we call it continuous monitoring, okay? So you start with planning, you do coding, you build it, you test it, you then release it to the ops team, then you deploy it, then you operate it, and then you monitor it. And this gives rise to five stages, that is continuous development, continuous testing, continuous integration, continuous deployment, continuous monitoring, which again goes back to continuous development. Now let's understand these terms. Let's understand what is continuous development, testing, deployment, monitoring, and integration. Okay. So this is the life cycle, guys. Now, why are we calling it continuous? Continuous basically means it goes on and on, right? It never stops. So like I told you in the diagram for DevOps, that the cycle goes on and on. It never stops. The product is always being developed, right? It is always in some part of the life cycle. So if you were to explain continuous development and continuous integration, continuous testing, this is the best way to learn it. Okay, so we have a developer who basically will be pushing his code to a version control system. Okay, and this version control system will basically, any changes in this version control system will be taken up by a continuous integration tool. Okay, so what is a continuous integration tool? A continuous integration tool does nothing but it joins each of these stages to each other. For example, if I have to go from continuous development to continuous testing, and if this happens in separate softwares, continuous integration will join these and this, right? Continuous integration will join testing and then deployment. Continuous integration will join monitoring and then again coming back to development. And how does this happen? It happens like this. So there is a software which basically does continuous integration. Okay, let's understand just this as a black box. This is a software which does continuous integration, and the function for this particular software is the moment you push your code to a version control system, this version control system is nothing but a software which takes care of storing your code. Okay, so the moment you push your code to a version control system or you change your code in the version control system, the continuous integration tool automatically identifies, okay, so there's a change in the version control system. So what it does is it takes this code and it builds it on the testing server. It first builds it and tests it on the testing server. And this is called continuous testing. Reason being, every developer who does this, continuous integration does the job similarly, right? So if there are 100 developers in the team, so for every developer, if we configure a version control system that for every developer it has to test the code, it will always do that, okay? So every developer who's doing a version control, who's pushing his code to version control system, continuous integration software is going to test their code on the testing server, right? And this is the reason it's called continuous, right? Because it happens continuously. Okay, so continuous development, we push our code to version control system, it is identified by the continuous integration tool. So the first job that continuous integration tool does is it pushes onto the testing server the code where it is built and tested, and if the test succeeds, continuous integration tool pushes it on the production server. Okay, now either if it's on the production server or if it's on the testing server, now if on the testing server there are some bugs which are identified, the feedback is given through continuous monitoring to the developer. Or if the production server, if there are some problems on the production server, or like I said, when you deploy your code on the production server, it basically gets available to the world and it gets continuously monitored, right? For any kind of problems which are occurring, it gets continuously monitored and the logs are generated, and these logs are being stored somewhere using continuous monitoring. So your production server is continuously monitored for any kind of activity which is happening on it, and the logs are being generated. Now the developers, the team, now when I go back to the developer, why am I coming back over here? Because this identifies, or this tells us basically now, that now when the development team is done with the release and now they have to see what other work I have to do, all they have to do is check the logs from the continuous monitoring tool, right? And they'll be able to identify, so this and this is causing a problem, this and this is causing a problem. And also the users are saying that, you know, we should have this feature. The client also came in, he also wants some features. So they plan a release, right? And once they plan a release, they again start coding. And again, once they're done with the code, they'll push the code to version control system, which will be identified by the continuous integration tool, which will then automatically test it. Once it's been tested, if it's successful, it'll push to the production server. Again, the logs will be identified by the continuous monitoring stage. Again, it'll go to the developer after planning, and then he'll code his way into version control system, and the life cycle goes on and on, right? So this is exactly how DevOps work, right? Now let's look at each of these stages independently to understand what exactly happens in continuous development, what exactly happens in continuous integration, okay? So in continuous development, you basically push your code to a version control system. The version control system could be a software like Git or a software like SVN. Right now, the moment you push your code to the version control system, it basically creates a new version of your code. For example, if you wrote ABC on a text file, right? Now that ABC you wrote and you uploaded on the version control system, so this was the first version. The version control system automatically makes it version 1. The moment you make some changes and again push it to the version control system, what happens is it creates the version 1 was the text file having ABC. Now the new version that you have pushed, it becomes version 2 and the file would be ABC and probably whatever changes you have made to the file. Okay, so it creates a new version and at the same time it also holds on to the previous version so that in any case, in any problems that you might have in the future, if you want to revert back to the previous version, you can easily do that, right? And that is why we have version control systems like Git and SVN. And continuous development is an integral part of pushing code to your version control system, okay? Now, this was continuous development. Then you have continuous integration. Now, what is continuous integration? This is nothing but integrating your life cycles with each other, right? For example, once you push the code to your version control system, it obviously has to be picked up and pushed onto the testing server for testing, where it could be built and tested, right? So all these life cycles are integrated, or there is someone who is doing the manual job of a person of taking code from one stage and pushing it onto another, then taking the results from there, pushing it onto another, then taking the results from there, pushing onto another. And that manual effort is being done by a tool which is called the continuous integration tool. Okay, then you have continuous deployment. Continuous deployment basically means you will deploy your code onto a particular server. It could be a testing server, it could be a production server. And deployment basically involves putting the right kind of software on it and then pushing the build onto your server so that it has the right software environment where it will function, right? And again, installing softwares and system and everything is also automated using a tool which is used in continuous development lifecycle. Okay, then we move to continuous testing. Now continuous testing is again a lifecycle stage wherein you continuously test your software. So like I told you guys, in this what happens is you continuously build and then test your code. So your code is pulled from the version control system. It is built. So when I say built, it basically is converted to an executable file. And this executable file is then run, right? Now the continuous testing, how it happens is you create testing suites, which are basically pre-installed in the testing server. And the moment it gets a new executable, all those test suites are executed on this particular executable file to check if all the tests are passed or not, right? And if all the tests are passed, it is then again picked up by the continuous integration tool and then pushed onto the production server. Once it reaches the production server, again, it gets monitored, right? It gets monitored for user activity. It gets monitored for any errors. It gets monitored for any user comments on version upgrades, right? On version upgrades, or you can say any feature requests. So all those feature requests, all those errors, all those logs are then visualized or then are then stored inside a monitoring tool, right? And this monitoring tool helps us in sorting these logs based on what we wanted. It'll basically sort it on the basis of general logs, it'll sort it on the basis of error logs, it'll sort it on the basis of feature requests, right? So it becomes a one destination stop for you where you can check and plan your day ahead or plan your team's work for the near future. Okay, so this is continuous monitoring. So these were all the lifecycle stages of DevOps, guys, and this lifecycle stages basically make it possible for us to have shorter release cycles because all these stages are automated, right? And these are automated using tools, and these tools we'll be discussing in our next session, where we'll get an introduction to all the tools which basically come together to create a DevOps. So in our next session, we are going to talk about DevOps tools, guys. So this brings us to the end of this session. So have a great day ahead and goodbye.